In this video, we will briefly discuss placeholders and how they differ from text boxes. We will also briefly discuss sizing and adjustment handles. When I open PowerPoint, it displays a default document that contains two placeholders. Clicking on the New Slide button allows me to select a number of different layouts. When I select a layout, some of these placeholders have the ability to add tables, charts, smart art graphics, video clips, clip art, or images. We will discuss these in more depth in a later video. I may, as we will discuss also in a later video, create my own layouts and control how I wish the placeholders to appear on those layouts. For a beginning PowerPoint user, a placeholder allows us to quickly add objects and text to our slide. But we do not have to use placeholders, and most PowerPoint users do not. You can very easily select the placeholders that appear on a slide. I click and then drag with my mouse, holding down the mouse button, drawing a square around the objects I wish to select. I can press the delete key on the keyboard, and they are deleted from my presentation. If I want to add a text box, I can click on the insert ribbon and then click on text box. This causes my mouse cursor to change into an insertion cursor. Wherever I click on the screen, it will create a text box at that location. I begin typing text, the text box will expand to accommodate the text that I type. If I wish to move this text box around the screen, I move my mouse cursor over it, wait for my mouse cursor to change into a movement cursor, which is an arrow pointer over top of four arrows. I can then click and hold the mouse button down, dragging the text box to where I want it to appear on the screen. If I want to resize my text box, I can use one of the adjustment handles and click and drag, changing the size of my text box. This will automatically cause the text within the text box to wrap. The adjustment handles have different functions depending on their position. The adjustment handles in the corner allow the text box to be sized diagonally. This is indicated by the change of the cursor into a diagonal double-headed arrow. The adjustment handles in the middle sides of the box allow the text box to be adjusted horizontally. The adjustment handles at the top and bottom of the text box allow the text box to be adjusted vertically. Notice as I move my cursor around the screen, the cursor changes to reflect the action that will be taken. If I see four arrows like this, it allows me to move the text box. If I see a vertical I-beam, it allows me to edit the text within the text box. I can then go back to selecting the text box when I see the four arrows and click. Another adjustment handle is the rotation handle. It's a green circle above the text box that allows me to click and rotate my text. If I hold down the shift key while rotating, I can rotate at set increments, allowing me to snap back to a perfectly flat horizontal position.